let's go to page 927 and let's do example one. Example one, you're looking for equation of the tangent line to the hyperbola y equal to 3 over x at, so you're looking for tangent to this line at 0.31. So what you need to do is, again, to find a line, so you're looking for this tangent line, so you need to look for the slope and another point. So again, you start with just a graph. So it doesn't matter what this looks like, just kind of have, just draw something so you can have something to visualize. So here's your point one, which is 3, 1. And here's your point two. So you don't know, so it'd be x and a y. And over here, you know what y is. It tells you y is 3 over x. Okay, so what you want to do is you want to update that, so make it into x and 3 over x. Right? That's the y, right? So again, that's a y. And so you're looking for the tangent line. So you're looking for this tangent line right over here. So you're looking for this equation, the equation of this line. Again, when you're looking for equation of the line, you need to have a slope and you have a point. So right now you have a point. So you need to look for the slope. Okay? But again, because this is a curve, you only have one point, so to find the slope, you have to use the limit. Okay? So again, you start with the definition, right? Again, slope equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. But again, because you have only one point, so you have to use the limit. So slope equal to the limit of, and so you start with this point, and you want to bring this point as keep going to this point, right? So you want to make the x2 become x1. So you want to have x approaches to 3. Right? So whatever this is, you want this approach to this point. So that's where this came from. So that's your x2, that's your x1. So you want to make x2 approaches to x1. And over here, the y2 is 3 over x, y1 is 1, and x2 is x, and x1 is 3. Okay. So in this case, again, you cannot substitute 3 in there directly. So you need to do something to this to make it so that you can substitute. So you have a complex fraction, so what you want to do, you want to multiply by the common denominator, which is the x. So you want to multiply by x, and you want to multiply by x, right? And when you do this, right, don't multiply out this part, because you the purpose of doing this is so you can cancel out this part. Okay. So the slope equal to the limit of x approaches 3. So when you multiply out, you get 3 minus x, right? You distribute. And over here, you get x minus 3. Again, the whole purpose of doing that is so you can cancel out this part, because you cannot substitute this directly, right? Now, when you cancel this, it will give you negative 1. So this will give you negative 1. So the slope becomes the limit of x approach to 3 of negative 1 over x. So in this case, now you can substitute, so slope equal to negative 1 over 3. Now, once you find the slope, you can find the equation of the line, right? So again, so this one, the m equal to negative 1 over 3. So this is m equal to negative 1 over 3. So now you have a point and slope. So now you can find the equation, right? Again, there are a couple ways you can do this. So you can use the point slope form, which is y minus y1 equal to m times x minus x1. So you're going to get y minus this is your first point, so that's your x1, y1. That's your second point, so that's your x2, y2. Right? Okay. So y1 is 1, the slope is negative 1 over 3, and x1 is 3. Right? So use your point slope form. Then go and multiply everything out. So you got y minus 1 equal to negative 1 over 3x. When you distribute, negative times negative is positive. 1 third times 3 is 1. And then you plus 1 on both sides. So you got y equal to negative 1 third x plus 2. So that's your slope intercept form. Okay. Now another method is using the a and the b. So slope equal to negative 1 over 3, which is equal to negative a over b. So the negative matched. So a equal to 1, b equal to 3. So right away you're going to get 1x plus 3y equal to 1 times parentheses plus 3 times parentheses, right? 1 came from here, right? 3 from here. And the blank is the point on the line. So the point on the line is over here, right? 3, 1 is on the line, so you can use that point. So you substitute the 3, 1. So I'm going to cut the code for you so you can see where it came from. So the 3, 1 is that. So that's where it came from. So you get x plus 3y equal to 3 plus 3. So x plus 3y equal to 6. So that is your standard form. Okay. Now let's go to example 2. Example 2 is the same as example 1. Right? You're looking for the equation of the tangent to y equal to x cubed minus 2x plus 3 at 1, 2. Again, you just sketch a curve. So here's your point 1 and your point 2. So point 1 is at 1, 2. And this one you don't know, so it'd be x and the y. Now, instead of putting the y, here is the y, right? So y is equal to that. So x and the y would be x cubed minus 2x plus 3. Okay. So this is your x2, and that's your y2. This is your x1, that's your y1. Okay. So again, you're looking for the tangent, the equation of the tangent line. So you're looking for the equation of this orange line over here. Okay. So you have the point on the line, so you need to look for the slope. Okay, so that's what you're looking for. But again, because normally you need to have two slope on the line, right? Normally you need to get 2 points to use the slope, right? But because you only have 1 point, therefore you have to use the concept of limit. So again, start with the definition of the slope. Slope is y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. But because there's only 1 point over here on this line, you can right now this point 2 is not on the line. So you cannot just use that directly. Okay? So again, you have to use the limit. So slope equal to the limit. So you want to bring the point 2, get closer and closer, right? So you want to make it x, right? That you want to make x2 approach the x1. So again, that's your x2, that's your x1. So you want to make x2 get close and close to x1. And so y2 would be x cubed minus 2x plus 3. Right, that's your y2. The y1 is 2. Right, so y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Okay, so that's what you have. So again, right now you cannot substitute directly, so you have to do some simplifying. So slope equal to the limit of x approach to 1. So you simplify this part, you get x cubed minus 2x plus 1 over x minus 1. So now you have to, so right now you cannot substitute directly, so you have to try to factor that and cancel. So in this case, this is the cube, so there are a couple ways you can do this. One way is by using the synthetic division. So you got 1, 0, negative 2, 1, divided by 1, right? So that's your 1. Now there's no square term, that's why it's 0, right? Minus 2 plus 1. And divide by, you set this equal to 0, you solve, so x equal to 1, right? So synthetic division, you drop, multiply, you add, multiply, you add, right? So this becomes, so when you divide, so when you divide, you're going to get m equal to, so when you divide, you're going to get the x squared plus 1x minus 1. Right? That's what this is, right? Now, if you don't remember your synthetic division, then you can use the long division. You can use the x cubed minus 2x plus 1, and you can divide by x minus 1. So you get x squared, so you multiply x cubed minus x squared, right? And put parentheses around that, you subtract, so that way you remember to subtract this one. So you get x squared, drop the next one. So this one, you need to get plus x. So you multiply, you get x squared minus x, parentheses around that, subtract. So it becomes negative x plus 1, and you drop, right? Drop the term. So you're going to get minus 1. So you get minus x plus 1. So it come out exactly. Okay. So either way you get that. So now you can go and evaluate. So m equal to, so you can put 1 in here. So you're going to get 1 squared plus 1 minus 1. So m equal to 1. So once you find m equal to 1, right? So now you have a point, you have a slope, so you can use a point slope form. So you get y minus y1 equal to m times x minus x1. So you substitute, so y minus, okay, y1 is 2, slope is 1, x minus x1 is 1. So y minus 2 equal to x minus 1, and you can plus 2. So y equal to x plus 1. And that would be your equation for that, for this line, for the tangent line. Okay. So that's what this is. Okay. So again, it's very simple concept. Okay. Again, all you're doing is just looking for the slope. Then you use the point slope form. Okay. But to find the slope, you have to use the limits because you only have one point on the line. Okay. Because it's a curve. Okay, let's go to example 3. Example 3, it says find the derivative of the function. So you have the function f of x equal to 5x squared plus 3x minus 1. And you're looking for the derivative. Derivative means the slope, okay? And the way to write it is that, so this is the derivative. So you're looking for derivative of the function at 2. So that's what you're looking for. So you're looking for derivative of this, or the slope of this graph at x equal to 2. Okay. So again, you sketch the graph. Here's your point 1, here's your point 2. Now this point 1, it tells you x equal to 2. Okay. So you're looking for, again, the derivative means the slope. So it's the same thing as what you do earlier. It's the same thing. So at the 2, so you got x equal to 2, but you don't know the y, right? In this case, you don't know y, but you know the function. This is y. So you can use this to find y at this point. So y is equal to 5 times 2 squared plus 3 times, so here's your y1, okay? That's your x1, right? So again, to find y1, you use the x1 into the equation. 3 times 2 minus 1. So y1 equal to 20 plus 6 minus 1. So y1 equal to 25. So from here, we can see that this is a 25. Okay. Now over here, the second point, you don't know what this is. So you're going to be x. And the y, this is your y, right? Again, f of x means y. So you got 5x squared plus 3x minus 1. Okay. So you can let your x1, y1. Let your x2, y2. So you're looking, so basically, this means, again, so what we need to do is we need to go ahead and find a slope. And so this means you're looking for the slope, right? the derivative or the prime, the f prime means a slope. So you're looking for the slope of this line at x equal to 2. Okay? So again, so you start with your definition of the slope. Slope equal y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1, right? But because there's only one point on the line, okay, so you got to use the limit. So slope equal to the limit of, so you want to get this point, get close and close to this point, right? So you want to make the x2, that's your x2, approaches to x1. Right? So you want to make the x2 get close and close to x1. So again, that's your x2, that's your x1. And your y2 would be 5x squared plus 3x minus 1. So that's your y2 minus y1 is 25, right? Y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. So again, y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Again, you cannot substitute directly, so you have to simplify the fraction. Now make sure you follow through with all this. You have m equal the limit, right? So you get 5x squared plus 3x minus 26 over x minus 2. And what you want to do, you can divide using long division, divide, or you can just do the factoring using master product. So if you use master product, you get 3 and negative 130. So from here, you're gonna get 13 comma negative 10. Another way of doing is just go and use a long division, just divide. You get the same thing. Okay, so you're going to get 5x and 5x. So this would be minus 2, right? 5 times negative 2 give you negative 10, and this would be plus 13. So this will cancel out. So m equal to the limit of x approach 2 of 5x plus 13. Now again, m is a slope, okay? So slope, another way of writing a slope is f prime of x. So again, f prime means a derivative. So slope, derivative, f prime, they all mean the same thing, okay? So again, slope, that's what this is. So slope and f prime is the same thing. So this will equal to, actually when you evaluate, you want to have x equal to 2, right? So f prime of 2, that means the slope at x equal to 2 equal to 5 times 2 plus 13. So f prime of 2 equal to 10 plus 13. So f prime of 2 equal to 23. So again, what this saying is that the slope, okay, the slope, f prime means the slope, right? The slope at x equal to 2 over here, the slope equal to 23. Okay. So that's what it means, right? Again, f prime means the slope. Okay, let's go to example 4. So all the previous examples, we have numbers that we can use. But in example 4, you don't have numbers, so you really just have to apply the definition. So f of x equal to square root of x. And so a, you're looking for f prime at a. So what you do is, again, you start with the general graph and call this point 1, call this point 2. Okay. Now, since they don't give you numbers, so they tell you that that the first point, you just have to label. When you don't have number, you use variable, right? So first point, I'm going to call this x, and the y, right? So again, if the x over here, then the y, the f of x will equal to square root of x. Okay, so that's what that is. Okay. And the distance between them, this is the h, right? H is how much you have to go, right? To get to the next point. So this is x plus h. And so when you put this in here, you're going to end up with square root of x plus h. Okay. So again, that's your x2, y2. Okay. So whatever you have x2, you put in here, right? See, that's your x2, so you put in here, and that's how you get that, right? So again, you put x2 in the square root. That's how you get y2. And that's your x1, y1. So again, you start with the definition of the slope. The slope equal to y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. And so again, first you need to find this slope over here, right? Okay. So slope equal to the limit of, so you want this approach to this, right? So you're going to have, as this approach to this, since you're using the h, okay, you're gonna use the h instead. So again, when this approach to this, h is gonna approach to zero. Right? H is the distance. So as you get closer and closer, the h is gonna get smaller and smaller. So when this point gets to here, the h becomes zero. So again, when you don't have any number to deal with, then that's what you wanna do. Okay. So y2 is square root of x plus h minus y1 is square root of x. Okay, now x2 minus x1, so x2 minus x1 is h, right? Again, so x2 minus x1 is the distance between these, right, which is the h. So now that's what you have. Now, when you see the square root right away, you need to know that you need to multiply by the conjugate. Okay, so you need to have a x plus h plus square root of x, square root of x plus h plus square root of x, right? So when you multiply the conjugate, now do not multiply the other part. So you can multiply the conjugate, but the other part, okay, do not multiply. So you're going to have h. The purpose of not multiplying is so you can cancel out, right? Because right now you cannot substitute directly. So when you multiply the conjugate, this one you multiply, you're going to get x plus h. Negative times positive is negative. Square root of x times square root of x, you get x. And so when you do this, right, this is going to get canceled out. Right, this and this will cancel out, and h will cancel out. So this becomes 1 over square root of x plus h plus square root of x. So the slope, so now you can substitute, right? When you put a zero in here, you're going to get 1 over square root of x plus square root of x because h equal to zero. So m equal to 1 over 2 square root of x. Okay. So now, so that's a slope, which is means f of x, right? F prime of x equal to 1 over 2 square root of x. But now you're ready to evaluate. So part A. So a, you're looking for f prime of a. That means whenever you see x, you make into a. So this be 1 over 2 square root of a. Okay. Now for b, so that's answer for part a. For part b, you're looking for f prime of 1. Well, f prime of 1 means you put 1 in here, so it'd be 1 over 2, right? So you put 1 over here. Okay, let's do this in square root of 1. So equal to 1 over 2. F prime of 4 equal to 1 over 2 square root of 4 equal to 1 fourth. Okay. And F prime of 9 equal to 1 over 2 square root of 9, which give you 1 over 6. Okay. So you just have to get used to learn how to set up the problem and just apply the limit.